This contrived overlap rebounded on itself.
Loop 3 should be the last one.
I keep coming back to this page. The author's clearly awake. It's like he's warning us. But about what? I mean, what does it mean? This page scared Jules away from the work on Wake's writing. But coward can't stand risk. Science is risk. For me, this is proof that we are going in the right direction. I just need Rudolph Lane's paintings to lead to more pages so that hopefully one day we can understand. I keep coming back to this page. The author's clearly awake.
Locked. Maybe there's another way in. Controllable shifting phenomena. Won't open without power. Thank you. You again. What happened to you? Did the people here do this to you?
Mammoth! Clogging his head!
Alan Wake's writing is being studied here. Do you know anything about him?
Names don't matter. A thousand more to come.
They say clear communication is the key to any relationship. You and I have some work to do there. You said marmots before. Do they do this? Where are they now?
Misery!
Tell me where they are.
The man in the white coat.
Christ. It's fixated on the marmots. What did they do? A threshold is the connection between a foreign reality and our own. Now, they all have their own rules, strange as they are. But the further down I went, the more chaotic this one got. Clearly, this was the Cauldron Lake threshold, but something was wrong. Well, more wrong than usual. Finally, someone who isn't a painting. Hey, hello. Who are you?
Sorry, got a flow going. Can we do this later?
No, we cannot. I'm Agent Kieran Estevez. I'm with the government, and I need your name.
I'm Ed Booker, the playwright. and I'm hitting my stride here. So can you guys stop with all that banging and screaming? It's throwing me off.
What are you even doing? What are you writing?
Well, after you all abducted me in the woods, I've been working on this manuscript you gave me because you need it for some experiment or something. I kind of forget the premise. But, you know, I've had this block lately, and filling in the gaps of this story has really loosened me up. Copying the style is a nice constraint, but I still have lots of room to play. It's a solid creative exercise.
Where do you think you are right now?
In an immersive writing workshop.
Well, bad news, it's not a writing workshop. Good news, it's not a writing workshop.
Right. It's a government facility studying the power of creativity. That makes way more sense.
Look around you. How is this a workshop?
You have to stay in character. I get that. I'm in the theater business, too. And look, the sets, the costumes, all great in that, you know, campy, 70s sci-fi kind of way. But you could dial down the role-playing like 15, 20%. Just some professional advice.
Sir, whether you are aware of it or not, there is a situation here. I need you to stay in your cell until I can resolve the matter, okay?
Uh-huh, got it. Hey, no one's been around with food for a while. I could go for some dinner when you have a second. Oh, and can I get my phone back? I want to call my wife. I don't know how Tammy found you guys, but she killed it. 5 stars all around.
Yeah, I'll get right on that.
Creativity tearing through the shadowy cloak of corporate cookie-cutter bullshit. Kill a metaphor. This is good stuff. Your style's a little clip. I can work with that. Short, to the point. Visual metaphors on dark imagery. Government is spreading darkness, trying to control the uncontrollable. It speaks to climate change, oppression, the disenfranchisement of immigrant minority populations. Lots of heavy themes in a dark sci-fi wrapper. Love it.
I wonder what happened here.
Jules Marmont looked at the painting. He didn't understand it. Saw only random whirls of color. Drugging Lane made him more compliant, but his work had turned abstract. Jules needed more art his team could parse, could test. Trial and error. These abstract explosions of color complicated the data. His grip tightened around the letter opener in his hand. The piece of art he needed was hidden inside Lane. If Jules could simply cut the painter open and pull the painting out of him, he would. The overhead lights flickered. Jules would make Lane cooperate. No more drugs. Less carrot, more stick. Jules had to go faster. He wouldn't lose to Diana. Nothing else mattered.
I can't paint anymore. I know you want me to paint, but I can't. I'm empty.
Rudolph, no. You love to paint. And you are such a talent. This is just a classic artist slump.
No. No, I hate it. It's just taking from me now. When can I leave? You said you'd let me leave.
Ah, Rudolph, but you volunteered to come, remember? We are helping you, like Dr. Hartmann did. Perhaps you need to see our doctor? I can arrange that.
No. No, that's... I am feeling better. Much better. I will paint.
Ah, this is wonderful to hear, Rudolph. I knew you would come back to your old self.
open while the floor's on lockdown. Oh, there's the elevator. How do I get in? How many paintings did they have this guy make? Access card. Sorry, but I need this. not right.
Turn back. Area is extremely hostile.
Fucking radios. They're on floor one. I'll need help.
had a thought today. A possible avenue for further research. When we think of art successfully affecting reality, we always think of Alan Wake and his writing. This could be due to recency bias or simply the amount of recorded evidence skewing our opinion. But also, I wonder if writing's very nature is an advantage. Text can describe events in such explicit detail. The story gives the shadow a, how you say, blueprint, a map of what to make real. But not all art is like this. Music, sculpture, dance, cuisine, in our case, a painting. When the source material is open to interpretation, how will the shadow choose to interpret it? I think Diana will find the question very interesting. Most likely, she already has an answer. That's why I love her.
Shaded. Hope that glass is thick.
Shut up!